Gentleman from seven.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Nullification, stating that the federal law does not hold in Idaho. We might change null, void, and of no effect to be merely just of no effect, but the end result is the same. I oppose this bill as a violation of the Constitution of the U.S. and of the Constitution of Idaho, both of which I have sworn to uphold. And I'm in good company. George Washington said nullification is, quote, preposterous and anarchic, unquote, and would lead to the dissolution of the Union. Democratic President Andrew Jackson used military in the 1830s to enforce, in South Carolina, federal law over the Articles of Nullification. Republican President Abraham Lincoln gave his life opposing nullification and secession. Republican President Dwight Eisenhower used military to enforce constitutional civil rights to education in Arkansas. And our own Attorney General finds this nullification position untenable and illegal. Why? Because that way leads to dissolution and anarchy. If we can set aside this law, what's next? No one could count on a uniform system of laws. What does that do to businesses who trade nationally and internationally? They really do need stability. And what does that say to the treaties if any state can just say no? We are a nation of law for the legislature of Idaho or of any state to override our Congress, our courts, our laws, our Constitution is arrogant and incorrect. And therefore, this bill deserves a red vote.